Dear friends, I have a little update on quantum healing and where we are with that whole concept. So if you're familiar with some of the concepts quantum mechanics, you may have heard of tunneling. So what is tunneling? Tunneling is a process where a particle, like an electron, can pass through a barrier that, according to classical mechanics, it shouldn't have enough energy to overcome. Here are the key points on quantum tunneling. Particles are treated as having wave-like properties. The wave function of the particle has a non-zero probability of existing on the other side of the barrier. The probability of tunneling decreases with the barrier's width and height. This quantum tunneling is crucial in various physical and biological processes like nuclear fusion and protein folding in our biology, in our cells. Then there's the other concept, which is teleportation. And so teleportation in the context of quantum mechanics refers to transferring quantum information, not the actual physical matter, from one location to another. So here are some very interesting key points here in this information on teleportation. Quantum teleportation requires entanglement, a phenomenon where two particles become linked, showing the same fate regardless of distance. The Alice particle is in Andromeda, and Bob particle is in the Milky Way galaxy, and doesn't matter, the distance doesn't matter. The information of a third particle is transferred by manipulating the entangled pair, achieved by transmitting classical information through a traditional channel and the entangled state through a quantum channel. So currently, this teleportation is limited to transferring information about a single quantum, or say single quantum bits, not entire objects. So what are the key differences? What is transported? Tunneling involves the movement of the particle itself, while teleportation only transfers information. And the underlying principle, tunneling relies on the wave nature of matter, while teleportation leverages the phenomenon of entanglement. Right now, the applicability of this, tunneling is a fundamental phenomenon observed in various physical and chemical processes, while teleportation has potential applications in quantum communication and computing. So just comparing the two, in summary, tunneling allows particles to overcome barriers in seemingly impossible ways, while teleportation enables the transfer across distances, but not the actual physical object itself. So if this is true, then let's look at other phenomena: teleportation, tunneling, superposition, uncertainty, creativity, imagination, and discontinuity. These seem to have both mind-like attributes and quantum qualities. So do they share some characteristics? And yes, of course, mind-like attributes and quantum properties are related. Here's a breakdown of the connections. The mind-like attributes, teleportation, the idea of instantly transporting information or matter across vast distances, resonates with the concept of telepathy, the ability to transmit thoughts or feelings over a long distance. Tunneling, the ability for particles to seemingly pass through barriers in the quantum world can be seen as a metaphor or similar to overcoming seemingly insurmountable obstacles in the mind. Superposition, the ability of a quantum system to exist in multiple states simultaneously, can be seen as analogous to the complex and multifaceted nature of the mind, which can hold multiple thoughts and emotions at once. Uncertainty. The inherent uncertainty associated with quantum mechanics aligns with the subjective and ever-changing nature of our thoughts. And of course, feelings. Creativity and imagination, the ability to generate new ideas and possibilities can be seen as mirroring the unpredictable and innovative nature of the quantum world. Discontinuity, the sudden and unpredictable jumps that can occur in quantum systems, can be seen as similar to the discontinuous leaps of insight that can happen in the creative process. So here we are, you know, very similar attributes. The mind has similar attributes as quantum mechanics that refers to physical reality at a very fundamental level, including our biology. So right now, science has definitely established that photosynthesis, which is responsible for all life on Earth, the energy of the sun, photosynthesis, without which we would not be living beings, is quantum in phenomenon. Bird navigation is quantum in phenomenon. Olfaction and sensory processing of information through the eyes for vision is quantum in phenomenon. Other senses are also seemingly quantum in phenomenon. Motor activity or motor and sensory activity, which go together, are also quantum in phenomenon. Intentionality is quantum in phenomenon. And the process of morphogenesis and differentiation, how a fertilized egg becomes a baby, has many quantum aspects to it. And so does epigenetic modulation of genes, seems to be modulated through quantum principles. So this, if this all bears out, then quantum mind and quantum biology are linked. And it gives support to things like intention, visualization, meditation, creativity, and everything that we as humans aspire to with self-awareness. So self-awareness is also quantum in nature. If you understand all this, then, and not worry about the latest science or math about this, because that will take time, then quantum healing will become at the forefront of self-regulation and self-healing and homeostasis. Let me know what your thoughts are on this.